Previously on Cabbie on the Street.
Go stay at the guest house?
I would love to.
All right.
We can?
I'll look out for you, man.
Bryant, yes! Serving up a facial on your
man! I didn't get your address.
So you want my address?
Yeah.
It's 8 Out of Your Mind Avenue.
Of course, no lead is safe against the Lakers because of this man, Kobe Bryant, to take over.
1-800.
Never, ever, 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 ever call me, ever.
The following takes place between 12 p.m. and 1 p.m.
What's up, everybody? It's your man, Cabbie, here in Los Angeles, sitting next to one of the baddest ball players on planet Earth, a global star, Kobe Bryant. How you doing, sir?
What's up, man?
I'm chilling, man. I'm chilling. Good to see you again.
Thank you.
I feel like you. There's the adoration is back. Like,
yeah.
Because, you know, we left it off kind of, you know, it's kind of like this, but now it's like this.
Yeah.
No? Now, that's a bad sheriff hat.
You know what? When they were casting Brokeback Mountain, dude, they really should have casted you in there.
They should have casted both of us, Kobe, because I feel the mutual love and adoration. Kobe.
Do you really?
Kobe and Cabbie.
1-800, man, 1-800.
There's like this iconic West Coast figure,
uh-huh.
Tupac. He wrote this record called Me Against the World.
Uh-huh.
Now, being an elite athlete and being yourself, do you feel like you have to carry that sentiment into battle every night?
Well, that's a good mentality to have sometimes. You know, when you go into battle and you feel like it's you against the world. You know, you kind of let it all hang out.
Bryant, hesitation, gets inside. He also moves from Kobe Bryant.
You cannot allow him to go down the middle.
Every court you step on, you know that the opposing coach is like scheming against you. And like,
yeah.
You got a target on your back all the time.
You know, the way I approach it is us against the world. Because, you know, everybody doesn't think that we really have a chance to get back to winning the championship. So I think that we have something to prove that nobody else thinks that we can prove.
They say second coming, the new beginning, the truth is speaking, you should listen.
Much has been made of your number change going from 8 to 24.
He wore 8 for the first 10 years of his NBA career and now switches to his old high school number, 24, Lower Merion.
Bryant wearing number 24 this year, changing from number 8.
Among other things, does that signify a new Kobe or like a different kind of leadership from you?
No, it for me, it just symbolizes taking each day at a time. That's what it stands for me. I mean, it's just 24 hours in a day, just walking one, putting one foot in front of the other. This is my 11th year in the NBA. It went by fast,
yeah.
You know, and really not having a chance to really appreciate every moment. So going forward, it's kind of the vow that I made to myself to make sure I enjoy every moment.
Has your leadership style changed? Obviously, you lead by example, but are you like more of a vocal guy? You got a couple of young fellas on the team. You sort of an older brother figure to those cats?
I am kind of an older brother, actually. My leadership style has changed just because the personalities on the team change.
Right.
So when that happens, I mean, you have to be able, as a leader, you must adjust to the personalities of your teammates.
A lot of their success tonight going to be based on Kobe Bryant.
You're guarding Kobe. I mean, you can be a defensive specialist, but you're going to need a lot of help.
Kobe got the deflection. You have a red. Kobe with a tomahawk.
You know, it's kind of, I'm sort of lucky in my position because I suck at a lot of stuff, and you're great at a lot of things. So, like, people never target Cab, but they target Kobe. I just have a moment here.
We just walk around asking people to stay at their crib and stuff.
I've referred to you, I don't know if you saw the episode of Cabbie Unlimited, but I referred to you as my Jack Bauer. Kobe Bryant is out to assassinate anybody on the basketball court.
He's my Jack Bauer.
Sorry, but we need your car.
Hey, easy, all right? Go ahead, take it. It's yours.
Thank you.
Jack Bauer, the main character of 24, he's like in like relentlessly focused, all right? He's always in the zone. Gave you 24, Jack 24. Yeah. Now, like, how do you know, like, it's gonna be one of those nights for you when you are like just, you are stymieing your opponents. You're like focused, you're in that zone, you got tunnel vision.
Well, I normally know when I can predict what adjustments they're gonna make, you know, because I'm prepared and I'm on top of my game. And once I know what adjustments they're gonna make before they make them, then I can adjust to that.
Okay, wait, so are you talking like you're seeing two or three things like ahead of time? You're seeing like refracted light, Kobe. You
just you have the ball in the post and a double team comes from the top. Okay, you score.
Kobe Bryant goes baseline, double team. Bryant trying to find some room, somehow kicks it in.
So the next time down, you predict that a double team is going to come from the baseline. You know, so you anticipate that, so you go middle where there's no double team.
Bryant double team.
Oh my goodness, Kobe with the fadeaway.
So you start seeing, you know, the rotations and the schemes play out before they play out.
You're on some mastermind game. Yeah, you are. That is cool.
It's preparation, man. Just taking a lot of time.
So it's not like anything like you're not like you don't eat like Golden Grahams or Captain Crunch when you're chilling in the Maybach on the way to the game, let's say. Cause I want to be in one of the zone two someday, Kobe.
Yeah.
And I'm trying to extract some information from you, Kobe. Whether it's from
you invade my personal space. You're too close to me.
Why? Because this is a moment for me.
We cool and all that, but you know what I'm saying? Yeah.
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 All right.
Personal space.
Okay, I'll just hang out over here then.
Hey, you do your own zone.
Yeah.
I do my zone. That's your zone. This is my zone. Okay. 2-4 zone. Cabbie zone.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, that's cool.
We're all good though.
The first time we met,
yeah,
it was about a year ago this time, and then we were in Toronto, and I said, well, Kobe, we're gonna be in Los Angeles, the crew, and then I asked you if we could stay at the guest house, and you politely said, yeah, you could come stay at the guest house.
And I'm not sure if you have like an additional room at your house, maybe for like one or two nights,
stay at the guest house?
Casa de Bryant.
You wanna go stay at the guest house?
I would love to.
All right.
We can?
I'll look out for you, man.
We say, okay, so we're in LA now. I brought an overnight bag home, we got since we're having a sleepover, got some CDs. This is for Vanessa if she wants Aguilera, you know, the Aguilera record. I brought, you know, the Clips, got the Black Album, Kingdom Come record.
Yeah.
And then I have I brought my own toothpaste and a toothbrush, because I don't want to burden you.
Nice packing, man.
Thank you.
You got toiletry bags for that nowadays.
I have a pillow. Because I don't know if you have extra ones.
You don't think I have pillows at my house?
No, but I think...
I don't have pillows. We run out of pillows.
Yes.
So we don't have pillows at my house.
No, you...
We don't have toothpaste at our house.
No, I don't want to insult you. Because I don't want to be a burden, Cole.
Yeah.
So with all that said, can we actually make it official? Can I stay at the guest house?
Sure. Would you need the address or something?
Yeah, you know what, I tried to call you,
uh-huh.
And then I put the number you gave me in the phone last time.
Yeah, who
it's
picked
right
up?
Here. It's
1-800, never, ever, ever, ever call me, ever. Yeah.
Thanks, Cole.
Yeah, I look forward to your call.
Yeah, I changed that though.
You changed it?
Yeah, I changed the number.
Oh, we'll get, can we just update and get the new
one? I don't have the new one yet.
I wasn't getting through with the old one on call.
You didn't get through?
No, it's the roaming, something's up with the roaming and...
Well, you gotta get a better service then, that's your fault. You lose connection, you can't be losing connection, man. What kind of phone you got, man?
Oh, was just a trio.
Nah, you know what I'm saying? You gotta make sure that your reception is up to snuff. Cause see, if I knew you was coming, I would've had you taken care of, pillows and all.
That is against my bad, huh?
Yeah, I don't wanna point the finger, but... Kinda. I tell you what, I give you an address.
Okay.
You can stay. 1-2.
1-2.
5-1.
5-1.
Compton Boulevard.
Compton, okay. Is it a, is
you know where Compton's at, right?
I do know, yeah, I know where Compton is.
Just go down there, man, just ask him, ask for me. Go to that address right there. If that address don't work, just ask anybody on the street, man. Just ask anybody on the street where Kobe live and they'll tell you where I live.
We're at the 1200 block of West Compton Boulevard here in Compton, California. I'm looking for Kobe's house, and it figures that he would send me to a house of sorts, a house of God. Let's see what the service looks like. It's over. Maybe Kobe's in here. How are you, young lady? Not too bad. I'm just looking to see if Kobe Bryant's here. No chance? Newport, oh, he said he lived here. No, Kobe's not here. It doesn't look like he's, this is where he lives, at 1251 Compton Boulevard West. I don't see him here. Well, it looks like he didn't come to church today, but the pursuit continues. Maybe I just need to go hang out in there and just have a few moments. I think this is where I probably should go and say a few things. I'll be right back. What time are you gonna be home? Because I will show up when you show up.
I'll be home around 1 a.m. That'll work good for you.
Compton at 1 a.m. Sure, okay, well, let's make that happen. L.A.
Matter of fact, I'm on my way down there right now.
To East L.A.?
Yeah.
Okay, can I come?
Can you come?
With you, accompany you.
No, not really. You once again, you know, my zone, your zone.
Okay.
Right?
Yes.
So you do your zone, I do my zone, and somewhere down the line we can connect zones.
Cool.
Okay? But just go down there.
Yes.
Right? You're asking for me.
Yes.
All right? And then I'll point you in the right direction. All right?
Thanks, Kobe.
You got it?
You're the best, Kobe.
Thank you.
Ever.
Thank you.
And I like that this is now step 2 in our relationship, friendship.
It's a process.